What's going on, guys? We're back here with another Destiny video where we're taking a look this time at every single primary arc weapon. There are a lot of options here. There are actually a total of 8 to be exact. So with this week being a ArcBurn Nightfall, or if you're watching this at a different time in the future, anytime there is ArcBurn, you want to know what's the best weapon to use, what's the best circumstance to use different type of weapons. That's what this video is hopefully going to pass on to you. So as you can see, starting off like we did with the Void primaries, if you guys haven't seen that video, make sure you check that one out as well. But starting off, we're going to start here with the Anguish of Drisden, I'm not sure how you say it. The Adept version does arc damage, and this is what I'm going to say, bottom of the barrel. That's what I'm trying to say. Bottom of the barrel as far as arc primary weapons. Now, it's a solid auto rifle. It has crowd control on it, and being a taken or from the King's Fall, it does have the cocoon perk, which on a primary really isn't that useful from what I've seen from when I've used these. It has decent stability, but there are so many other better arc primaries that if you do have this, it's a very, very situational, where maybe if you go into a ArcBurn taken strike one day, you want to use this. That would be the only thing that might make you want to use this. Otherwise, this is a great candidate for a weapon that's fun to collect, but just keep it inside your vault. All right, so next up, we're gonna be taking a look at two weapons, actually, at the same time. We're gonna be looking at the Oversoul Edict and the Praetus Timepiece. Both of these pulse rifles have very similar stats as far as impact, rate of fire, reload, stability, all that good stuff. Now, of course, Oversoul Edict, you get some bonus perks that help you out with the Hive, and Praetus Timepiece, you get that bonus perk where it helps you take out oracles. Other than that, you know, I have Field Scout highlighted here, doesn't really do anything right now. And then Oversoul Edict, the nice thing about that, does shoot full auto, and then Praetus has the Headseeker, which is very nice as well. But as far as being the best arc primary, no, very good arc primaries, but definitely not the best. Which leads me into yet another arc auto rifle, the second one on this list, but not even the last one, there is yet another. But let's first talk about the Necrochasm. First thing I'm gonna say, if you're looking for fun factor, Necrochasm's probably the most fun arc weapon to use, with that whole exploding curse thrall thing where when you get kills. This thing is a blast, especially when you're going through the lamp section in Crota's End. This thing is actually pretty useful there, because when all the thrall gather up, you just shoot a couple of them and then they all blow up. But as far as being the best arc primary, this one still falls a little bit short. It is a bullet hose archetype, and it's got a whole bunch of great perks for an auto rifle, and the fact that they changed it where you don't have to get a precision kill to get that cursed all explosion, you just now need to get the any kill, makes this weapon a lot more usable and a lot more fun to use, but still not the best arc primary. Alright, so now we're halfway through the list, went through the bottom four, let's take a look at the top four, and you guys may disagree with me here, and of course I always want to hear what you have to say in the comments down below, but coming in at, I guess, number four from the top, it's going to be the Fatebringer. This thing hits like a truck, it does tons of damage, tons of impact. Exploding Rounds, Firefly, and Outlaw. It's an amazing hand cannon. But what I like to do is I like to look at where are you really going to use these primary arc weapons. It's going to be, for the most part, Nightfalls or, story missions. Anything that has the ArcBurn modifier on it. You know, you're not going to take the ArcBurn version of the Fatebringer into the Vault of Glass. You're probably going to take the Legendary one if you have that. So that's why this one falls to number four. The range on it, it's still great, but you still have to get somewhat close to some of these enemies, and in those activities, you usually want to try to keep your distance. All in all, amazing weapon, blast to use, one of the best hand cannons in the game, in my opinion, especially for PvE, but still falls short of being the best arc primary. Alright, so for the last three weapons here, it's really about personal preference. These are all amazing arc weapons to use. Very usable in any situation, but of course gotta rank them all, and that's what the whole point of this video is. So coming in at number three from the top, we got the Chaos Dogma. I actually thought when I started making this video that this was gonna be my number one choice, but after using it a little bit with all the other weapons, I actually had this jump in at number 3. Now, it's got the triple double perk, which is amazing if you're bringing this in to shoot bosses. You know, if you can keep getting those crit shots, you're going to shoot this scout rifle over and over and over again. That triple double perk keeps on proccing, and you got the extended magazine as well, so you can get a ton of shots off of this thing, plus the impact is massive. Thing that really hurt me with this was the rate of fire and stability. When you're going into nightfalls, especially the one this week, stability is key, especially if you've got tons of enemies firing at you. You want to be able to take them out as quickly as possible. You don't want to miss any shots. And the rate of fire is also key as well. You know, if you've got a whole bunch of enemies swarming at you and you can't shoot fast enough to take them down, that's where the Amalon Chaos of Dogma falls a little bit short. Again, amazing weapon. I ended up using this in my Nightfall run this week for the solo run, for part of the run, but you'll see that when that video comes out. So that is what's coming in at number 3, and at number 2, we're going with the Zalo Supercell. The Zalo Supercell has been around for a while, for all of year 2 actually. This was the only arc, or the only elemental primary actually, so this thing has been around for a while and still at the top of the list, in my opinion. This thing has great exotic perks on it. You know, the fact that you can, you know, shoot into a whole bunch of enemies, it kind of has that bad juju thing going on where if you do get double kills, you're going to get ammo magically respawned. So as long as you're getting multiple kills over and over and over again, you can essentially continue to fire this and never stop. Another amazing weapon for the lamp section in Crota. You know, you can just lay into the thrall and you never have to stop firing for the most part. And did I mention it also boosts up how fast your supercharges? So yeah, amazing perks on this thing. Very, very useful. The range on it is what actually knocks it down a little bit in my opinion. That's why we did not give it the number one slot. So that leaves us with the number one weapon, which is the Fang of Eru. Fang of Eru scout rifle is amazing. In my opinion, one of the best guns in the game that I've used as far as arc primaries. You know, this thing's got third eye, so radar stays active when you're aiming down sights. Really useful in PvE when you've got tons of these enemies all around. Perfect balance. It's got the perk, which I forget what it's called right now, but it's on the second one on the tree, where when the magazine is empty, the reload is lightning fast. Now you can see from the stats up on screen now, the reload is already lightning fast. So this thing almost reloads immediately when you completely empty the clip. Now it's got not the greatest impact, but the rate of fire makes up for it. This thing just continuously shoots and shoots and shoots, and the fact that you can reload as fast as you can just keep laying into enemies. And the stability makes this thing a laser beam. You know, you can take out enemies from across the map and you don't have to worry about your shots kicking off, missing, or anything like that. Great weapon, Fang of Eru. That's it, that's the list. Yeah, so those are my rankings for all the Arc Adept, or whatever it is, Arc primary weapons. Do you guys agree? Do you disagree? Did I miss something that you think was overlooked about one of these weapons and should have been higher on the list? Or maybe something should have been lower on the list? I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. So make sure you let me know what you think. If you guys did enjoy this video, make sure you're hitting that thumbs up button. And if you're new here, always hit that subscribe button. I'd love to see you back on the channel. If you're enjoying the video this much that you're still watching it, I kept your attention that long, so maybe you want to check out some of my other stuff, guys. So, as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.